Alright guys, today we're back with another banger, and today I'm just going to be showing you, let's just start things off with the fact that, well, you can see that I'm just in a vehicle, right now I live in a car. But I hope to change that here in the near future. Right now, I just gotta trust in God. You know what I'm saying? I just gotta trust in God. He's the one who's really keeping my life together right now, to be completely honest with you. Him. And let's go out and have an adventure, shall we? Let's go do something. Let's get out of this hot car. You get some water. I'm gonna get some of that on my way out here. Yeah, we're gonna get some water real quick. Alright, we got the water real quickly, you know what I'm saying? Well, let's take in the day, shall we? It's a very beautiful day out. Let me just say that. It's very bright, but it's not too hot because we have a nice breeze. And I want to say the temperature itself actually feels significantly less than yesterday. It was like 96 or 94 yesterday or some shit. It was really hot. Not very much breeze at all. I don't even think we had a breeze yesterday, to be honest. It was just straight heat. Heat with no air. And even if you got caught like a draft of some sort, it would usually be like some hotter air than not. But today, quite the contrary. Very nice day today. Very beautiful day in Arizona. Very beautiful day for filming, that is for sure. Let's win together, guys. Let's have a winning day. Let's have a win. Let's have a win. Are you fucking retarded, stud? Come on! No, but, oh, yeah! Peace and quiet, am I right, guys? Industrial society and it's complicated. Goodness fucking gracious. Industrial society and its consequences. That's what it is. That's what I'm trying to say. Ted Kaczynski was a little wild, but he wasn't exactly wrong. But yeah, walk around the city, all these cars, middle of the concrete jungle, you know what I'm saying? I'm a gorilla in this concrete jungle. Yeah, man, I'm that great one gorilla out the concrete jungle. Looking from the dope cause I just shot a bun. Scarecrow, make the chopper jump. I wanna be where nobody bothers you. I wanna be where nobody bothers you. Put good in, get good out. That's what I always heard it's about. As a lady, I highly doubt. That's true, cause we're living in a drought. People hungry, babies starving. That alone sure true. Dude, there are no normal G59 fans.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
No, like every single time I've met a G59 fan in real life and tried to have a normal conversation with them, they usually close themselves off and become like antisocial, and they become like weird, you know? I just catch like a weird vibe from them. See, they act like I'm stupid. Like I don't know what G59 is. Like I don't know what Great 5-9 is!
Get a load of this guy!
Boy! That's what's that. Now, when I went to Grey Day, though, last year, I actually met some pretty cool people. Good as fuck. All this traffic, dude. Barely think, barely talk, but... Throat's getting dry. Sucking too much dick. Oh, shit. Are you guys going to Grey Day? Are you guys gonna see Bones live? Are you guys going to the Loserville tour? I think that's what it's called, Loserville. I just find it really strange that I've never properly gotten to meet a Sesh fan or a G59 fan. Yo, if you're a Sesh fan or a G59 fan and I see you out here, I want to shake your hand. I want to know what your first song from either of them was. You know what I'm saying? I want to connect on that thing. You know, I love connecting with people on music. Music's like one of my biggest passions. I find ways to log on computers during the week, whether it's at a library, like on my own computer in an office. Because in the financial firm that I'm in, that I told you guys about in one of my previous videos, we actually have an office down there where I have a little bit of space so that I can use my computer in. But we are here at the park. Maybe I can just sit on this bench over here. Oh, look at the duckies. Hello, duckies. Hello, duckies. I want to eat one of them. You know what I'm saying? How about that? Yeah. Wait, that doesn't look right. That looks right. Anyway. I need some water. Let's get some water. Ah. I don't support interracial couples. Oh shit, what did that say? It's pretty windy here. It's a very nice breeze. Like I said, it's a nice, beautiful day. You can see the wind picking up on my hair, blowing the leaves away and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Can I set this up? I think that's just right. I like that angle right there. Oh shit. Tell me you can still see me, gang. I can barely see you. It's so bright outside. But we got a fresh pack of American Spirit Blacks today, my friends. Yeah. Yeah. Carcinogens over cardio, baby. Gotta say, it's a beautiful day for smoking a cigarette. That is for sure. This is great cigarette smoking weather. As long as you can light one up, you know, against the wind, which is why I bring one of these bad boys. Every single time, I always bring the Don't Tread on Me Zippo lighter, all right? You see it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go! After like three tries, I finally got it. Hey, third time is the charm, right? That is what they say. These glasses look so ridiculous, dude. Bro, I found these for like $5 somewhere. Because, get this, my old pair of sunglasses lost their lens. I don't know where it went at all. So today I had to pick up a new cheap pair of sunglasses for like $5. And, well, they are doing me justice. They are doing me work. They are actually keeping out the sunlight as much as they need to. But they are such a completely different look. I kind of dig it. I'm not going to lie. I kind of dig it. What do you guys think?
What do you guys think? What do you think? What do you think? What do you think?
This video is about being homeless. How long have I been homeless now? I've been homeless since like February, really, honestly, like beginning of February is really, the beginning of February. I had my flight at the end of January. Where I went to the Midwest for a little bit, back to my homeland, to do some potential filming. I was going to actually film a few different videos there, but I just couldn't, because my time there got cut very short by the circumstances. I didn't want to rely on my friends too much, to be honest. I know it's a lot on them whenever I'm just staying in their place for a night. Even if it's just for a night, I feel like it's a lot for my friends to pick me up. So, Tyler, if you're watching this, I really appreciate everything that you've done for me, man. Straight up, you're a homie, man. Quentin, too. My boy. We've known each other for so long, man. We've known each other since the glory days of Black Ops 2. We've known each other since, like, the fourth grade. We met a lot of different people who came and gone, you know what I'm saying? Not everything is going to be perfect, you know what I'm saying? Each and every one of my friends, even those who I didn't mention, I really do appreciate everything that you were able to do for me while I was down there, and all the time that we spent together as friends too. Like, straight up, I want to spend more time with you guys. I want to do more things with y'all. I want to connect more. I want to live a life of adventure. You know what I'm saying? I want to do some really fun things with you guys. I really do. Something that homelessness has taught me is to really look within for what you believe in, for what you love. You have to look within. You have to think back genuinely to your childhood and to what your childhood passions were. I'm not saying that. What I am saying is to look into your childhood passions. What did you love as a child? What did you love doing? What did you love watching? What did you look up to when you were literally as young as 6 years old, as 3 years old, as 9 years old, you know, whatever age that you can look back on, that you can think of, whatever number it is for you, look back on that. Seriously, go back to a day as early as possible. For me, it's like 3 years old, right? 3 or 4 years old. I knew that I loved gaming. I'm not even gonna lie. And to be honest, this has made me realize just how much I miss playing World of Warcraft, either with myself or with other people, and mostly the latter, right? I usually played it to play with other people, to make new friends, to play with my existing friends, you know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm going to be doing when I come back to the game. I'm going to be building a whole new guild. I'm going to be bringing in the people together who really want to play the game, to enjoy the game for what it is. And on top of that, I'll be forming a competitive team who will compete in the Mythic Dungeon Invitational for the next season when I come back to the game, or whatever next season is after I come back to the game, right? Because I wouldn't want to come back on, say, season 1 on War Within and compete for season 1 War Within. That's not how that would work, because I will need time to get back into the game for 1. Like, for 2, I really need time to get to know my people, to get to know more people, you know what I'm saying, to establish that friendship once again, to establish the consistency of logging in and playing with the people, you know what I'm saying. And then time to form the guild, time to form my team. You know, I need all that time, but I only need one season to do that. I only need a couple weeks, solid weeks of doing that, to be honest. I move quickly. I really do. I work quickly. That's just how I work. I work to get things done. It could be taken in like a weird way to where you might not enjoy the game as much if it becomes work. But you gotta work for the things you love. And me personally, I'd be happy for the rest of my life if I could literally play games for the rest of my life. Like on stream for you guys to enjoy, you know, playing, you know, actually providing some useful content, like educational content at that, whether it be about life, whether it be about the game itself. Cause I wouldn't just be playing the game all completely. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not the only thing that I would be doing all my life. Life is so much more than that, obviously, but a big part of my life will be gaming. It will be getting on World of Warcraft. And I'm happy to acknowledge that. I'm actually more than happy to acknowledge that. Because it's what I love. Life isn't just about playing video games, right? So, I want to get in that spot where I'm able to stream for you guys, hit the gym, do all these fun things, even make IRL content still for you guys like this. I still want to do that. I still want to venture out and do all of these adventures and do all these cool things. Man, don't let your adventure stop, right? You're allowed to dream big. Do not sell yourself short. Most of you who don't think of yourselves as great salesmen, you're actually the best salesman in the world. You know why? Because you sold yourself short on your own dreams. You sold yourself short on the things that could have been. So really, when you think about it, you at home, you are actually the best salesman ever. If you sold your dreams short, which I hope none of you have, because you don't have to. You're allowed to dream big. Dreams are meant to come true. They're not just meant to be dreams. Dreams are oftentimes visions too. And that's another part of looking within. You have to look within when you dream. Like, is this a right dream for you? Is this the right vision for you? You know what I'm saying? And 9 times out of 10, it is going to be the dream for you, right? You just have to live it out. You have to trust it. You have to go with you have to honestly pursue this life knowing the fact that we're all gonna die, right? We all have these like mortal bodies on this earth, but here's the good news. We're not gonna die forever. As long as you give yourself and you believe that the Son of Man really died on that cross for our sins, that the Lord Jesus Christ is the Lord and King of Kings, you have another life in heaven. We have new bodies waiting for us, ladies and gentlemen. This isn't the end, but it is a solid beginning. And this earth is basically a boot camp to really test you. This boot camp really tests you. This whole planet, this whole life is a big test for each individual out there on whether or not they find God or they turn to Satan. It's as simple as that. If you don't turn to God, you turn to the other one. Being a coward is equally as evil as genuinely representing Satan. And I'm not gonna live this life as a coward, you know what I'm saying? There's no reason to be afraid. Fear no man. Right? Cha-cha, eat another Zen. Me don't fear no man that can bleed like I can. from. Who else is excited for the new Suicide Boys album, New World Depression, coming out 6/14/2024? This is going to be a very, very nice listen, I tell you what. I'm very excited about this one. We're with nature, as you can see. It's a little part. Trenches. Featuring barbed wire on the ground. And there is actually a little place I could go down here, to be honest. I could actually try and walk in down here. It's just some it's some rough terrain, I tell you what. This is some really, really rough and rocky terrain. And it, ooh, look, what's in there? Oh shit! Is that a quail? I think it's a quail.
Actually,
that's pretty dope. That's so sick, dude. I love nature. I love God. I love Jesus Christ, the Son of Man. Another detail I could go into, I guess, is what do I do for things like keeping myself clean? How do I look so clean as a homeless person? How do I have clean clothes? Well, it's quite simple, actually, to be honest. Just need a little bit of money. A little bit. Not too much. You know why? Because all I need to shower as a homeless person is a gym membership. And the cheapest gym membership you can get here, at least in the city where I am, is at Planet Fitness for like $10 a month. Right? It's not the greatest gym by any means. I tell you what, I'm not gonna lie, I miss other gyms a little bit just because I actually do like the hit bag when I'm in there, the punching bag. That's genuinely something that I would do every single workout. And ever since I got a new membership at Planet Fitness, I haven't been able to do that because every Planet Fitness is full of babies and full of lady men who don't like punching bags, so they don't have punching bags in there, you know what I'm saying? That's just how it is. They're all about, you know, no criticism, no intimidation. It's gym class without the whistle. Ah, you're a lunk. We're gonna use a lunk alarm. I actually really like going to the gym later because there's one, there's less people. Two, it's cooler at night. How do I get my food? Well, I get food stamps, right? From the government, right? Because I'm homeless. Homeless, unemployed. Yeah, I mean, I get the full benefit, right? I mean, it is what it is. But I gotta say, speaking from experience, being homeless, or even not being homeless, getting food stamps in general, you have to be really, really careful. And you need to be smart with how you use that money. Because, I mean, simply because of inflation. Remember, if you shake more than two times, you're playing with it. Busy ass parking lot, dude. So many NPCs. I covered the fact that you gotta be careful with your money, with your food stamps, right? You gotta be careful with that. You have to. I mean, the best part about being homeless is all the money I make is all mine. I'm not paying anybody rent. I'm not owing anybody money. And the best part about being in the position that I'm in is I'm not required to clock in and out of work at a place where 40% of my fucking money goes to a glorified gang of elitist pedophiles. It makes me feel good, you know what I'm saying? It makes me feel good that I have the opportunity to make some tax-free money. One, taxation is theft. Two, it comes out to like 40% of your fucking paycheck. For all this bullshit, right? Social Security, right? Stuff that's not even gonna get used in the future, because we all know what's gonna happen with the stock market here within the next couple of years or so. It is bound to have, it's one of the worst crashes in history. It's been way too long since the stock market crashed. And the thing with all that money in the stock market, with Social Security, with 401ks, whenever the stock market crashes, all of that money also crashes. It also loses value. But not in life insurance, baby. Life insurance can't be touched by the government. Even though life insurance is a state-regulated thing, you have to get a license to do it. Go get him, man. Go charge him that $2,500 ambulance fee. Get him. Get him. Fast travel him to the hospital. Fast travel him to a healer. In some places, you can fast travel for a healer, and it may cost a hefty amount of gold. Oh, that's life, though. I gotta put my phone on the charger real soon. I'm on 10%, baby. We've been filming for quite a while. I probably got a solid video of this. Hopefully. I hope in some way this video has actually been informative, educational. Anything that I can do to provide a humble service to you guys, my watchers, my viewers, my homies. You want to become a homie? Be sure to subscribe to the Patreon, where you can see uncut, exclusive content. Talk is cheap, I keep my Cardi's on. Let it sing, it's that R Linux.